Hey guys, it's Corrales, and welcome everybody to Planet Coaster and Koali Beach. You might be like, Corrales, what is wrong with your voice, buddy? Well, today I woke up with the worst cold ever. Whatever you do, everybody, don't get papers. They're like small little germ factories, just germing all over the place. Not German people, you're amazing, I love you, but just germs all over the place. So it's bad, and tomorrow is my time for this episode in the amazing collab between me, Lay Designer, and Silverhead. If you haven't checked out those people, make sure you do that. Links in the description, everybody. But this is going to be a little quick recap before I start doing anything in the park. What has happened in the episodes which not been on my channel? Let's check it out. So this is the amazing... Oh my god, that's my voice. Where's my voice? Where's my voice? So I was saying, this is the amazing entrance Silver built for episode 1, which is still by far my favorite entrance of them all. I love it. It's bushy, it's palmy, and it's just perfect for the project. Then, episode 2. Lay Designer built this... Uh-oh, we got a situation, lady. We have a little bit of trash outside your restaurant place. She built this fantastic restaurant with some toilets over here. And ambiance is pretty fantastic so far. It's so cool having people in the park, even though this park is not like laid out with trash bins and stuff yet, so therefore it's a little bit on the messy side. Episode 3. I made some Bora Bora huts, and I think this is going to be tons of retweaking to do over here. We're going to make them a little bit smaller, like the area a little bit smaller with some jungle around. And I know some people are commenting on this, like, Kiraz, why this? Like, a lot of resorts or parks, they do have like a hotel inside of the resort where people can just rent a cottage, house, or hotel room once they are staying in the theme park, right? So that was my plan, at least. I still like this a lot. I think they look nice. It's not done though. It's a work in progress, all right? Then the master himself, Silverhead, built a coaster, and it's amazing. It's fantastic. I haven't yet been on it. I watched this episode and I'm like, buddy, how do you do it? It's fantastic. Like, there's something about wooden coasters as well, which just make stuff amazing. Like, especially like this game, Planet Coaster, is fantastic. How they have made this possible with all the wood beams. Like, just look at the little support structures. It's just phenomenal what they have accomplished in the game. Look at it. I need to take a ride. And even the station buildings and stuff over here. How beautiful isn't that? Then that goes up into this little creation, which is a little thing, which is beautiful. Alright, but everybody, you're not going to be listening to me the whole episode, because I know it's pretty annoying at this stage. But I'm just going to wait for a train, which is here. Your head, is that a fez? How do you do this, Sil? For those of you watching my Planet Coaster series, you know I'm terrible with coaster and track rides. How do you make it so smooth? Like, I mean, that ride was phenomenal. Previous week, Lady built something over here, which is a maze boss against, once again. It's called the Jungle Dining, and this is something which I will have used for in today's episode. We might even move this. We do seem to have a little bottleneck over here. Somebody's blocking everybody. Why this is going on? I just don't know, but there's some blockage just going over here. But look at it. How are people so good in this game? It's beautiful. I'm liking that as well. So that was the little recap. This has happened on the episodes which not been on my channel. And in today's episode, what I thought, this over here, like the little darker terrain, there's going to be a wiener, weenie. Sylph's going to build his wiener, weenie over here. It's going to be a big volcano, which is going to be erected in the middle of the park, and it's going to be big, and it's going to be like eye-catching. And then we're going to have attractions all the way around it, with maybe coasters and whatnot. So I thought like this, I'm going to make a ride. The Log Flume or River Rapids, and I'm gonna have it. I know what you're thinking, Keralis, don't do track rides, you're horrible at them. I'm gonna make it on the side of the volcano, which is not erected yet, but it's gonna be in the next episode. And then maybe Sylph can integrate his volcano into this type of thing somehow. And then we can even make use of this restaurant, move the restaurant to over hereabouts, and everything's gonna be amazing. So, let's get to it. Everybody, my voice is gone today. It's broken, it's bad, and it's super annoying. So let's have a time lapse. Let's listen to some music. Today we're gonna be using some music from Joachim Carrud. Fantastic guy. You can even use his music in your YouTube videos if you credit him correctly. Links in the description. So everybody, much love and enjoy. See you after the time lapse, all right? Oh, by the way, a good friend of mine, Sean, invited me to be a part of his music video, only for a few little seconds, but you know, I was a part of it. So if you want to check that out, do click it and show some love for Sean. Amazing guy.
Thank you.
I think we might have a people situation heading for the log flume. So everybody, welcome back. This is about 6 hours later from you last saw this place, and I'm sick. I'm sick and tired of blazing bushes and trees. So it's not done, okay? But I did as much as I could for this episode. This took quite a bit of time, and I'm actually liking this quite a bit. So far, so good. So let's just check this out. Look at it. I would need to check this out. Can I just go down on ground level here? Let me just see here. Just hide here in the bushes. Oh man, I know that boat is elevating a little bit in the air because you can't place them on this side. I still want to have a boat over here. We're gonna check that out as well. But I'm just waiting for this log flume type situation to arrive. Hello? No. Oh man, this is so awesome, this game. So I fought like this for the episode. Either I do a station building and a log flume, or I do some scenery and leave the station building as it is for the moment, because that would take him the whole episode just to do that. And I choose the first mentioned, some scenery, just so you guys can envision how it might look in the future. So the station building is here, and yeah, it's far from perfect, but it is working out. It's a little bit dangerous here on the sides, but we're gonna make this work, so don't you guys worry about that. Also, very nice scenery over here, which is just a mismatch of stuff. We're gonna get there. I do love stuff like this, for example, like how this log is just a hazard to everything, but it's some vines growing on it, and I mean, it just adds to the whole place. Also, I thought like this here, all the things here, we're gonna have like proper wood supports underneath those instead of those supports. But we will get there. Also, I did move the restaurant, and holy crap, Blaze Diner is a beautiful place, but it was a pain to move because, well, the restaurant itself and the scenery was not an issue. The paths, placing them later on into the whole shablang, that was tricky iffy. So if you're watching this, lady, make sure you go through this and check it out so I didn't make any mistakes. I can already see a mistake, I think. That this floor is a little bit too high because their feet is going in. I'm sorry, lady, I cannot screw that up, I guess. But it looks beautiful still. Like, look at it. Look at it. Jungle dining, then you go here. And oh my god, where are you guys coming from? Stop it! It just doesn't end. Everybody's gonna wanna go on the log flume. Oh, this is gonna be so awesome. So, next plan is, I'm gonna go through this. We're gonna take a ride as well. I left that side here mostly intact for the moment, because what I thought, Sylph, if you're watching this, buddy, if you could possibly integrate the log flume inside of the volcano, would be mind-blowing. Maybe if it was some like fire type of animatronics and whatnot, like special effects, it would look so cool. Even maybe cutting the track here about and making it inside of the volcano with some more drops or whatnot, that might be something. So therefore, this side is totally left out, also here up on the top, because I don't know how big the volcano is gonna be. Maybe this is all gonna be gone in the next episode, who knows. Here, by the way, is a little lookout point, so we go up the stairs here. People can go up here and then just take a peek at, like, literally everything. Let me just go down here, as you can see. So people can just be standing there, just waving at their friends and whatnot. It's a big, big work in progress, by the way. A ginormous one. But then they can just, like, oh, they're going, and they just run over here, and then, like, ha-ha! I just can't get enough of of this. So yeah, inside a little cave they go, and what I'm planning to do in the future is add tons of scenery so they have something to look at. Even though they do have a little parrot over here. No, it's a dove. Crap. But let's pretend it's a parrot because it's a jungle, right? I've been on quite a few log flumes in my days, and they're usually not that exciting. Besides, they do have like two or three drops, most of them. But what you do, you go on them because of the scenery, and it's pretty fun because nobody wants to get wet. Also, inside of the tunnels here, we're gonna have some lights, maybe some cave systems or decorations. We really haven't got that yet, but time will come. This goes underneath the station building, goes all around here into this little thing, goes out here, and then you can just wave on everybody, and it goes up inside of this big lift. We're gonna take a ride on it. You know what? Why not do that instead of me just showcasing you this? Some of the rock formations, by the way, I did grab some of the rock formations as a blueprint of the Steam Workshop. I'm gonna link those in the description, so do check them out as well. And a few of them trees as well, because placing this island by hand, which I mostly did, was a pain. Trust me, like placing rocks, every single rocks, and then just spinning and turning them around is so time consuming. But I think it turned out pretty well. You will have to let me know. Also, we do have a little protective unit over here, so they can't throw stuff at them. They can, because the holes are pretty big, but you have to envision, right? We can build a proper roofing, but I kind of think, like, this looks pretty nice. A little bit rough, but it looks beautiful. And there's a little pirate hut over here. I'm a little bit unsure of them, so I'm going to wait with that. Like, the pirate things, they do fit the theme, because it's a jungle, but I don't know. It might have been overused already in the game so far, like the pirates and whatnot. I did manage to squeeze in some extra boats here for the moment. We're also gonna add some pirates, I guess, here on the beachheads. And this is the biggest drop so far. It goes up here and through that into the little pond, and all the people here can just see the splashes. That was the main idea for me. Like, let me just here. Camera T. There we go. For them standing over here and seeing those log flumes going across. Let me just here. Is there anybody coming? Let's speed this up a little bit. Anybody? There we go. Hey, they look happy at least. It's time, everybody. We just left the station. Let's take a ride on this. And Sylv, if you're watching this, please make it interesting and super exciting inside of the volcano. If you want to do that. Because I can possibly see a dragon in there spewing out some fire. Maybe not a dragon. The volcano dragon. Because now it's like, what we are lacking here so far, we have plenty of jungle bushes, because this was the jungle theme in mind, okay? But we are lacking on like small detailed bits and pieces, like barrels, like animatronics, and stuff like that. Hi! We are pretty high up, let me see, interest points. Well, look at the little faces, look at the smiles on their faces, I mean, they gotta be loving this. Okay. Focus mode. Here we go, everybody. There's gonna be a bush hitting us in the face, though, but it's for science. There is although an angry parrot there shooting people in the faces because they are kind of splattering water. Oh, parrot, dove. Yeah, this fence might need to go down a little bit. Not sure it's too high up, but it's kind of cool just seeing like bits and pieces in the distance. Inside of the tunnels, obviously, there's going to be decorations as well and lights. Yeah, because I don't think we have any lights nowhere on this ride so far. So it's going to be fairly dark during the night times. And it just like lacks a little bit, like, you know, the little excitement. They still look very happy. Well, they sure do. So this goes underneath the station building in the future. A very rough area for the moment of the creation. Yeah, you know what? I like this a lot. Let me just wait until we come to this point over here. There we go. Hi! Don't spit on me! That is a little bit dangerous, I guess. That rock is super dangerous, but it's a rock. Not sure about the color combination either. Up here I want to have something, and I'm not really sure about what. A little temple would look super amazing, like a jungle temple type of thing. Not sure the space is too big. We're gonna see how big the volcano is, because maybe we can make use some of the volcano as well. To make something, like a big temple. Or some type of thing, I don't know. We're gonna see. Oh! It's coming to the drop! This game, holy crap, it's pretty awesome. So yeah, I didn't do much more of the track or the ride for the moment. We have a little lift here, but no drops anymore. We just have two drops on it, which kind of sucks. So therefore, Sylv, if you could make, because this is going to be going inside a volcano, if you could make some drops over here or stuff, that would be fantastic. Or I can make it in the next episode, if the volcano is up, that is. Some lights over here. I do love stuff like this, for example, like this little gap just in the tunnel. Just before we hit the... Oh, that was like glitching through, I didn't see that. That log is super dangerous, by the way. Bam, in the face. So you might say that it's not much, but it is a lot of decorations, at least for the moment. So I just want to say thank you so much for watching, everybody. I'm going to call this quits. It's been a very, very, very long day. My voice is a little bit better, but I do still feel like crap. And I'm just going to see you guys in the next episode of Planet Coaster. I so want to get back into the game. I will. As soon as we finish off a series, I think we might start Planet Coaster again. Or Cities Skylines. Who knows? We're just gonna see. But I am sure liking this. Lady Designer, I'm sorry about the second floor here. We will fix it. Because now they are knees deep in walking thing. But we can make it happen. It does work, though. There's no bottlenecks anymore. People have seemed to be... Okay, we need a little bit of trash guys over here, because we don't have any. And holy crap, there are... what is this? The water, pipshot water. What is that? Why is that so popular? What do you got here? Pizza pen. Does anybody want to buy from you? You look very happy, but nobody's buying over here. Or maybe... no. Mm-mm. Psych. So thank you so much once more. Smash the like button if you did enjoy, guys, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next episode of Planet Coaster. But hopefully this looks good. I think so, at least. Adios, amigos. Bye bye, everybody.